Senior personal finance correspondent Sharon Epperson joins us with some tips on what you can do right now to take control of your finances and save some money before the end of the year. Sharon, thinking about a lot of these things are stuff we should be doing throughout the year, but what are things that we should really be doing now as we get closer to December 31st?
Well, let's talk about some of the top concerns that a lot of people had going into 2018, and it starts with unexpected expenses. 4 out of 10 folks say that's really what I'm worried about going into 2018. Yeah. A lot of people were worried about making ends meet. And then healthcare, of course. So now, as we close out 2018, how do you rectify this if you're still concerned about it? In terms of those unexpected expenses, you need that emergency fund. And the great news is that we have seen interest rates rise on savings accounts. Hmm. And so this is the time to shop around, make sure you're getting the best rate that you can for your savings, for that emergency fund. You also want to take a look at budgeting. There's no way to make ends meet if you don't know what's coming in and what's going out. You can do it right on your phone. And the other thing to think about is who can you talk to or who can help you kind of figure out how to continue to keep to that budget as we close out this year. Check in with a financial advisor too.
You mentioned healthcare expenses, and that's certainly one that people are thinking about, not only what they paid this year, but what they do next year. What should people be kind of focusing in if you're worried about next year's costs?
One of the things that is very good to do, and I've done this myself, is to make sure that you kind of bundle or schedule as many of your appointments as possible before the year ends. If you have a flexible spending account with your job that you've put money into, know that you may lose that money if you don't use it. Some accounts will let you carry over $500 to next year, but some won't. And then in terms of a health savings account, which is a separate kind of account, you may want, for cash flow reasons, to make sure that you get reimbursed by the end of the year for
especially
that as well.
Especially if you have a big issue coming up this year, a surgery or a pregnancy or something, you know you'll be using those dollars.
Exactly.
The holidays, you know, it doesn't exactly put you in the holiday mood to start thinking about having conversations with your parents, your kids about budgeting. But when everybody's around, maybe it's a good time to grab them.
Well, I'm a little strange, so I actually think it's exciting.
You are a little strange.
I am strange. I fully admit it. But it's an important time to set up the legacy. I mean, this is the time when you're with family, you're with loved ones, and you want to leave a legacy of financial strength. Getting a copy of your credit report and your credit score is a very important thing to do. The other thing to do is check your beneficiaries. Make sure that they're the people that you want. If you had divorce or death in your family, you want to make sure the beneficiaries are who you want on your insurance, on your retirement accounts. And then the other part is the estate planning. And it's not just because I'm going to pass away. It may be, as we've talked about a lot, if something happens to you and you get ill. And I think it's a strengthening exercise. It's not a, you know, I'm so sad exercise. I know you're laughing.
You are
at me.
A Grinch and a weirdo.
I know. No, I'm not. I really,
having
you know,
said that, I just got my own finances in order. So
yes.
I hear you.
Yes. Well, you know, I'll say, you know, when my son complains of because I gave him a money lesson gift instead of a money gift for the holidays, I'll say, Becky said I shouldn't have done this, but I didn't listen.
It's good advice, though, and I finally do have a lot of this stuff in order. I've just done it in the last month or two, so I'm with you.